Okay guys, so this is my finished look. I hope you like it and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. It's a little bit long, but please bear with me and I'll be trying to post more often, and then I'll see you soon on my next video. Thank you. Peace. Okay, first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put my hair up in a ponytail, and I'll probably use this little flat clips just to make sure all the hair is out of my face. I'm gonna start with the MAC cream, strobe cream in pink light. I'm gonna apply this all over my face. I feel like my skin is a little dry lately, so I'm just gonna use this to kind of glow up my face. Then with my image foundation brush, I'm gonna use the MAC Studio Fix Fluid Foundation in NW25. This foundation, it's my color. I've used so many other foundations. This one is the one that matches the best. So this is the one I prefer for color. But when it comes to coverage, I think it's a medium coverage. I've tried the Lancome Tint Idol 24-hour foundation. I like it too, but that one is a little dry because it's very matte, very full coverage. So this one is very good at matching my skin, but it's not 100% full coverage. So just choose your foundation according to the weather, the area that you live, and your skin type. If you are dry, you might like it, you might not like it. So try to choose something that is a little more hydrating foundation. If you're oily or combination like me, matte foundations, you might like them better because they will give you more of a matte finish and last longer on your face and not start getting oily and shiny at the end of the day. But it's a personal choice. For me, I really like medium coverage with like a dewy finish, because I feel like the dewy finish looks more natural. There's nothing natural about makeup, to be honest, but we do it anyway. Okay, so as you can tell, this one has very good coverage, but it matches me good. And when I said it matches me good, you want to drag it all the way to your neck and make sure it blends well with your skin tone. If you can see a white cast or an orange cast, it's not your color. You need to find another foundation. My beauty sponge, it's already wet. I already washed it. And I used antibacterial soap, hand soap, to wash my sponge. I do it every day after or before I use it on my face to help stop the spread of bacteria that grows onto sponges. And then it transfers to your face, you're gonna start getting acne. Okay, now I'm gonna start by defining my eyebrows. I'm gonna use this Crown double-ended brush, has a spoolie and the angled brush on the other side. It is very similar to the Anastasia Beverly Hills. And for that, I am gonna use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Pomade in Soft Brown, which is a taupey brown, it's a light color. Previously, I bought the dark, I'm gonna try this one by itself. So I'm gonna start by tracing the arch. And then on the other side. I kinda like to do this on both eyes, just so that I can get them even. And then fill them in as I need to. Making sure both arches are as equal as possible, but it's impossible. We're not perfect, but we try. And I'm not grabbing any more product. I placed a little product on the back of my hand just to keep it warm and handy when I need it. I can just grab it from there. So I'm not grabbing excess amount of product. And then when I get to the corners, inner corners, I'm gonna drag the product up this way. And same on the inside. Because I do have hairs, but they're very sparse and empty. I have like empty spaces. And it makes me feel like my eyebrow is not a full eyebrow. So I'm gonna grab a little bit more of this product over here. And I'm placing the angle down and then dragging it up. Almost touching it with the small corner of the brush. I'm not applying a Once that's done, I will just brush it again. Not too harsh, also very, very light. You're not applying a lot of pressure. It's like barely. I bought one extra of the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. I bought the Light Warm, which is this one. It's still pretty light, but it's on the warmer side because I don't like the super yellow, pale concealers. They don't go well with my skin tone. And I'm just gonna place a little bit there. And I also need a wax. I need to wax my eyebrows. I can see a lot of little hairs under my arch. And sometimes that makes it hard to trace a new eyebrow because it's too much hair. Just go on the top of whatever you place the product and then clean the rest. Right here, we're just gonna drag it down. And clean the excess product. I'm gonna do the same. And like you can tell, this color is pretty light, even for my skin tone. Now with my another sponge, this one is by Real Techniques. I'm just gonna clean and blend excess concealer. I don't really like when eyebrows have like a white halo around them. It's not flattering at all. And I'm gonna use my lighter shade, Fair Warm. You can tell like it's almost like as white as my shirt. I'm gonna use this as a eyebrow eyeshadow base. Again, I'm just gonna place a dot and another dot. And with the sponge, I'm gonna drag it around, bounce it very gently on my eye just so that I can use it. I use this as a eyeshadow base. And today I'm gonna work with the new eyeshadow palette that I just purchased over the New Year's, and I didn't film any makeup look with it, but I've been using it a lot and I'm really, really happy I bought it. It's from another YouTuber. Her name is Carly Bible, and she did a collaboration with Anastasia Beverly Hills and came up with her own palette. I ran out of words. So this is the colors, very, very pretty. very spring too, so you can use this. It has a lot of neutrals, it has some warm tones, it has some shimmers and some metallics and foils. I love, love this purple shade because, you know, purple is my favorite color. And if you didn't know, now you know. So I'm gonna grab a fluffy brush, blending brush. This is the SS027 blending crease. And I am going to grab chai, which is this color. I'm gonna place that on my crease very lightly and start doing circles. I can do small, small circles and also dragging it around. Same color. They do have a little bit of a fallout, I'm not gonna lie, you can tell. And then again, I'm gonna do that on the other side. But that's why using eyeshadow base can catch all this product and make sure it does not fall out on your foundation. I really like the payoff of the pigments. They're pretty similar to MAC, which I am a 90s baby, and my favorite foundation eyeshadows are from MAC. I'm not gonna lie, I still feel like they have a lot of pigment and they're very good sizes on the pots for the money that you pay. This packaging and everything is beautiful, but sometimes the eyeshadows are tiny, as you can tell. So I don't know. What it's convenient is that you can take this whole thing on a travel trip, and it's good, convenient, put it in your makeup bag or anything, or work or school or anywhere you go. But the products, the foundations, I mean the actual eyeshadow is not as big as the MAC eyeshadow. But you know, you do you, I'll do me, and this is how it looks. I like it, I like the colors. This is similar to Settle by MAC. I think I use these tones a lot because they complement my skin tone. So knowing your skin tone is gonna help you make better decisions when it comes to your makeup. My concealer brush, and I'm gonna grab, what should I grab? This one on here is called Bolli. I don't know, that's what it says, Bolli. And, or Moo, I don't know. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, catch a tiger by the toe if you really want to. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Okay, Bolli. Bolli it is. I do that a lot. Like where I'm indecisive on what I want to do or what I want to wear, I do the eeny, meeny, miny, mo. I feel like it's destiny. But anyway, that's just me. And I'm packing it up, tabbing on my eyeball. And I'm gonna grab more, use the same thing. This is like a champagne tone. It's not like a super shimmery or foil eyeshadow. This is more like a neutral, beigey champagne, I will call it. And now I'm gonna grab my Smashbox retro water. I'm gonna spray the same brush and I'm gonna pack it again just to see what happens once you add the setting spray. It does give it another finish. Oh, and I can see a little bit of the speckles. It has a little bit of glittery speckles, but not a lot. It's just a little bit, maybe like 3 or 4 that I got in there. And they're cute because when you take a picture, this is gonna reflect nicely. And then I'm also gonna put it on the inner corner of my eye, just to give me a little more luminosity. Okay. Awesome. I'm gonna grab another brush just to get another accent color on my eyelid. And I'm probably gonna work with this brown over here, Boyi. And this is a small blending or taper brush. I'm gonna place this in the outer corner of my eye and blend it upwards towards the inner corner, very slowly. And I'm doing very small movements with my hand. It's basically just my fingers that are moving. Not my hand, but your fingers, if that makes sense. Okay, try to like breathe in, breathe out. Sometimes when I do bright makeups, they're nervous and their lids shake because obviously it's their day that they're getting married and they're like super jumpy and their lids twitch a lot. So I just like to tell them, okay, let's do a little bit of a breathing exercise and breathe in, breathe out. Because also when I tell them to close their eyes, they shrink their eyes, they're like this. And I can't do makeup if they're doing like that, if their eyelid is like that. They have to be relaxed. And the makeup and the eyelid has to be flat and relaxed so I can put the eyeshadows where they belong. So always breathe, making sure your hand is steady and not shaking. And if you have a lot of coffee, then drink water. Okay. Now I'm gonna grab another clean blending brush, like this one. This is also by Crown, the 511. And with this clean blending brush, I'm just gonna run it through, starting on the inner corner and dragging it out. And I drag it in the inner corner first, so I don't bring the darker shadow inside my eye. Okay, that's looking a little better. The light warm concealer at the bottom, and then drag it on the sides of my nose. Your nose. And when you're a makeup artist, you tend to buy way too much than you need. And then you just get a little bit bougie, like just trying to buy new things all the time. On my bridge of my nose, a little bit on the forehead, a little bit, because I don't want to make my forehead bigger than it already is. Now I'm gonna set it. I learned this new trick by Harouche, another makeup artist. She mixes four translucent powders, one by Huda Beauty, Laura Mercier, Ben Eye. Two by Ben Eye, which is the banana powder. I have the banana powder, luxury baking banana powder. This one was Kim Kardashian's secret. A lot of makeup artists use that, but it's too yellow. It's extremely yellow because it's a banana color. You can tell over here. I'm placing it in this paper towel. And this one is the Kat Von D translucent setting powder, and this is extremely white for me, as you can tell, matches my shirt, so it's not a good color for me whatsoever. And then this is the Laura Mercier translucent loose powder in the color Glow, but this was given to me by my coworker. She bought it for herself and it's too dark for her. She's a lot lighter than me and she's like, I can't use this, you might be able to use it. So I'm gonna do a dab of this on the powder, on the paper. So in this paper I have three loosen powder, banana, Kat Von D, and Laura Mercier. So now I'm just mixing them all. I'm mixing them here with this brush. So I'm just gonna grab it. I'm gonna grab this little lid and dab the excess on it. And I'm gonna start applying it at the bottom of my, where I place my concealer, basically. I'm gonna grab more. So I was setting the powder here. And what I like about doing this, mix is that my under eye concealer does not become cakey. Something about mixing these three powders makes it more luminoso, but not as drying. And I really, really like it. So I've been doing this trick for a few months now, I think since December. Whenever I do my makeup, I have to mix the loosening powder, the setting powders. I can't just do it like that anymore. I feel incomplete. I will assume that the same way that you layer eyeshadows, it applies the same for setting powders. So same concept, layering makes the makeup looks better. NARS bronzing technique. And for this, I am going to use a angular brush like this. No, I'm probably gonna do something more specific. And when you wanna create or give it dimension and structure to your bone, what I'm gonna use is a flat brush. I can't find it right now. I don't know what I did with it. You know, it's over here. Okay, so this is a flat brush that is good for creating structure on a very round face or a face that needs more shadows and dimension. So I'm gonna apply a little bit of pressure here and make sure my foundation is loaded with the makeup, with the powder. And I'm gonna suck my cheeks in. And what this creates is the line, which is from the top of your ear all the way here, about 3/4 from here to here. You do not want to go all the way here because it's going to create like a beard feel. Weird. Sounds weird. Anyway. Same thing. And now with this angular brush, a little more fluffy, we're gonna buff it. Same idea as when you blend your eyeshadow. We're gonna blend this bronzer. This is the NARS bronzer in color Laguna. And then I'm just gonna, whatever is left in the product, I'm gonna use it on my forehead. Cause look at this Rodriguez forehead. It's like a big ass forehead. Making sure you change the angle of your brush every single time when you're switching sides of your face. And I'm gonna create a little bit of shadow and cover this double chin right here. I'm gonna go in an angular brush manner, I will say, here and then here to create this kind of chisel jawline that everybody wants. Now, I did not notice how long my chin was forward. Like, I have a pretty long chin until I started doing videos. You start doing videos and you notice, you're talking to yourself on the camera, you start noticing all of your flaws. and to some extent you have to be okay with yourself and whatever it is, what it is, you know, you have one eyebrow higher than the other one, one ear higher than the other one, double chin, that's who you are, baby, and embrace it. So now I'm gonna use my beauty sponge and I'm gonna remove a little bit of this powder. At the same time, it marries the foundation with the powder and the bronzer. So everything is one, all together, coming together in one. Okay. Going about my nose, around the nose, around my mouth, just to make sure that everything is buffed and together, blend together. Okay. When this is done, I'm gonna apply my blush, which is going to be Peaches by MAC. It's this warm peachy apricot color. I love, love this color. I'm gonna swirl my brush on the blush. Tap the excess. Smile. A little bit here, a little bit there, a little bit everywhere. And I'm gonna apply my under eye. I'm gonna smoke out my lash line. Now that this is done, all the powders are set, I'm gonna grab this flat small brush. I'm gonna grab Bouillie of it underneath my lash line. And I'm gonna smoke it out. The way it is, I'm gonna curl my lashes. And now I'm gonna use a new eyeliner, which is, if I can find it, yay, it's right here. Inglot, this one, it's a new eyeliner that I tried. And it's pretty much replacing my Maybelline color tattoo or whatever I was using before. Ha, I don't even remember. Who are you? I don't know. Anyway, so I'm gonna use this color 77. It kind of came to my attention that all of the Inglot colors come in numbers. They do not have colors. It's just numbers, which is cool. I don't know. It's just different. Then I'm gonna close my eye. Sometimes I start with my left eye, sometimes I start with my right eye. It depends, but I'm gonna do a small wing. I don't want too much wing. Or maybe I shouldn't say, because sometimes if you mess it up, you end up having a big wing. And I don't know, we'll see how it goes. Now I'm gonna start at the inner corner. And then I'm gonna do the other corner, going in, back in. I wait. I almost poked my eye. You saw that, right? Okay, I did one line. I am not gonna do the wings until the end. I'm gonna do the other eye first. And I'm gonna do the other, grab more product, just to keep it warm in the back of my hand. And I close my products back in because I don't want them to dry. That always happens here in San Francisco. It's cold, the weather is cold, so all my products get hard. We don't want the products to get hard, we don't want other things to get hard, but not that. Sorry, that's inappropriate. Sometimes I am inappropriate. I try to stay on my best behavior when I'm working. So when I come home, I'm like all over the place. I'm sorry, Edgar. Edgar is my husband's name. Mm-hmm. That's why I take a little long doing this. Or now it's time for the wings. And I take for reference the lower curve of my eye, if that makes sense. Let me tell you why. Let me explain it again. So my eye has a curve, and if you were to elongate this curve, where would it end? So that's what I'm trying to create. I look at myself really, really closely. Open your eye big as you can, and then I'm gonna place my there, and I'll go up like that and then connect it on the top. There. Now let's try to do the other side. That's the trick. It's not always easy, and sometimes I don't get it even, slightly uneven, and it'll bother me throughout the day. But that's just me because I'm OCD. And again, open wide. Then I have my curve, my little line, and I'm gonna connect it. And fill in whatever space you need. There you go. And check. Could be better. This one is good. This one, it's a little more laying down, but that's okay. We're gonna leave it. I'm gonna spray a little bit of the Love Ritual again. A little bit, right? Burst those bubbles, or whatever setting spray is just setting, laying on top of the skin. Cara, we call this Rimmel in Spanish. Oh, by the way, I wanted to let you know, guys, that I am gonna do a video in Spanish and a video in English, alternating between them. So whenever you see the title in English, it's going to be an English tutorial. And then when you see the title in Spanish, you know, it's gonna be in Spanish. As I am Latina, and I feel very comfortable speaking in my home country language, but I am also living in the US and I've learned English here, and that's why I have an accent. So I apologize if I don't pronounce everything perfectly, but please bear with me. And if you're here and you're in Mexico or any other country that speaks Spanish, muchas gracias por suscribirte a este canal. And I will continue honoring my clients that do speak English and they don't understand a word in Spanish, but they also want to learn how to do makeup and they come to me with their questions. So that's why I will do one English, one Spanish. All right, so thank you so much for your support, for watching this long tutorials, long rantings. So I'm gonna line my lips with Strip Down. But sometimes I also want to rant and talk and just talk. And I think this is a new way for us to let it all out and say what we think in a respectful manner. Like, I'm not here to judge or to be scorn anybody or to be feel better than anybody at all. This is what I went to school for. I went to school for beauty, and that's what I'm sharing with all of you guys. That's it. I'm not trying to change anybody or make you change your life or whatever. It's just makeup. Now I'm gonna go in again with Hoover. This is another lip pencil by MAC. Sometimes I sit here and I do know what I want to talk about, and sometimes I'm like, I don't know. Let's see what comes out. For the most part, I think my makeup is going to be cohesive with what I'm wearing, if that makes sense. Although you can only see my shirt right now and my necklaces. And also, I do not know what lipstick I'm gonna wear, which they're all pretty much the same if you look at them, except this one. This one is the most dark, the darkest of them all.
The darkest of them all.
Anyway, this is Magic Wand, which is a very nude color. Might look good. Bellissima, or Angelo. I think I'm gonna use Angelo. And so I'm gonna go again with this concealer brush and kind of blend in the edges of my lip liner. There you go. I just don't want any harsh lines. And I'm gonna use, what's it? Angelo? On the center. And then here. Using the same brush. I kind of want like a powder finish and not so much of a super matte full coverage lipstick, if that makes sense. I'm gonna grab Strip Down again, or Hoover, Strip Down. Let's grab Strip Down again. Very little. I need to buy another one very soon. Like that. Very powdery. So now I'm gonna do my hair. I don't think I have an outlet near me. So I'm gonna do my hair downstairs at my workstation and then come back to film the ending. All right.
Whoa, the ending.
Okay, thank you so much for bearing with me through this rant video. I feel so much better about my anxiety. I look good with my makeup. I'm really liking it. And I'm really happy you guys are tuned to watch my videos. I hope you all guys stay safe. And then I'll see you soon on my next video, which I want to do a haul, which is like a spring, summer trip haul. That's what I'm gonna do. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on my next video. Thank you and peace. Stay safe, everyone.